Yo, what's going on YouTube? I'm back with another video and the bike is fixed, finally. Hold on. 2 weeks ago, my back tire gave out completely. My chain came off my sprocket, back tire locked up. I had about 4 to 5 spokes broken, my bearings were crushed. What else? Oh, I'm pretty sure I broke my axle, my shaft. But I got a new back tire. That was only, what, $100 freaking? A lot more than what I would have liked to spend. But, I mean, at least it's up and running now, so I can still put out videos, which is good, I guess. So the bike is all fixed, and now that everything is fixed and good, I'm thinking about maybe putting some upgrades on it or something. I don't know. Putting some upgrades on it would be kind of cool, but, you know, I don't really know, because I've already put a lot of money into this thing. About $415, I think, I put into this. I also ordered some new clutch pads, since mine were pretty darn worn down. And I got my new clutch pads on right now. Got a new back tire to clean the bike up and the engine so it's not covered in oil now. Looks really, really good. And it's running good. So, I mean, everything's pretty much back to how it should be, I guess. I'm starting to hear a slight noise coming from my engine, and I'm pretty sure I know exactly what it is. I think 2 to 3 weeks ago, I took my cylinder head off, you know, just curious, and in my jug, in the side of my cylinder, there was a spore in the side of the cylinder. It wasn't a very big spore, and, you know, I assumed, just overheating one, you know, it's not too good for it, but, I mean, I don't think it'll really affect anything. But, now, I took my cylinder head off again this morning to clean the cylinder head, because, you know, I just told you I cleaned my bike, and the spore had gotten bigger. Not too much bigger, but I could definitely tell it got bigger, and I don't really like it. I don't really like that. I really do not want to spend another $40 on a freaking piston kit and jug, because, you know, I only have $41 right now. That's it. I don't have any other money. I had to go spend $20 on oil and gas the other day, $100 for a new tire, another $7 for new clutch pad, so in the past month I've spent about $127 on this thing. It's ridiculous. I need a new spark plug too, because whenever I decelerate and then try and give it more gas, it shakes and vibrates, sort of thumps and So I'm thinking, you know, I'm missing in my cylinder. It's missing, it's not sparking. So I might need a new spark plug too. I looked at it this morning and it's a little worn down. There's another, what, $10? So $137? I'm gonna have to put into it this month, probably. Ridiculous. It is doing better on gas though. It is getting a lot more fuel efficient, which is nice. Go for top speed. That nice 44 tooth sprocket on the back, so it's really good on acceleration, but not too good on top speed. Although, I'd really take acceleration over top speed any day, to be honest. Another thing, if I feel like it and if I have the money, I think I'm going to put, maybe buy a centrifugal clutch kit for this bike, since, you know, the clutch that's on this when it comes, when, you know, you buy the bike and the kit, it's kind of a pain in the ass. You got to pedal and let out the clutch, and sometimes it will stall and all that crap. Centrifugal clutch would be a lot better, and I would like it a lot better. But I'm not 100% on it yet. I know one coming for a mile. Another thing, some of you might know what it is. A Baja or a Doodlebug mini bike. I may get one of those next, since two of my friends have them, and I've ridden them before, and those things are fun little bikes. I mean, the stock engine that comes on them isn't that good, but I get the 212s, the Torsi 212s, put on it if I ever got the bike, so it would have, a little bit more than double the horsepower. Thank you. right up here is where my bike started to give out. It started to make a weird noise in the bearing when it. That sounded weird. That sounded like something in the cylinder. I hope I caught that on camera. It's a three-legged goat. Holy crap. I shouldn't be doing that. That's weird. That was a three-legged goat. Kind of funny, but you know, I feel bad for it at the same time. Anyway, YouTube, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I might have another one up later this week, so you know, I hope you enjoyed the video. I think I'm up to about 84 subscribers now. So yeah, I hope I can get one of those doodle bug things. That would be fun. Or upgrade this thing so it's a heck of a lot better. So that's all I got for you guys in this video. Peace out, YouTube.